If you are convinced that you are in Koramangala, then you will continue to play as if that is true. So if your belief is that I am a body-mind, I am a limited entity, then you might continue to play that way. Nothing can get in your way. So usually what happens is, there must be some openness to drop the false belief. Okay. Many times it can happen that even for those who come to Satsang, it can happen that it is just some sort of a reinforcement. They want a reinforcement of a false belief. Are we taking this Koramangala example too far? No, I still feel it's a little useful. So you might say that, okay, just tell me how to be happy. Don't try to rid me of or bring me to Murugesh Palya. I just want to be happy in Koramangala. And I'm saying that till you have this misconception, you see, it is not going to be the end of suffering, because a lie just pinches, you see. There's bound to be a poking sensation in the play of this world, as long as you're believing a lie about yourself. That is the design of this play. As I was saying to Govind or to somebody else the other day, that mostly we become open to Satsang because we have suffered in life. We have seen that all our belief system somewhere is not bringing us to that contentment, that peace that we are looking for. So many times when you come to Satsang with that openness to drop the idea, Koramangala idea, even to say, I don't know where I am, for me that is enough. But if you want something for that one who is seemingly sitting in the other place, how can anybody help? You see? So, now we can replace Koramangala with the basic notion, I am something. I am a person. How many of us are willing to let go of this notion? That is openness.